Good morning, all of you. This is Dr. Krishna. Today we are going to see chapter 3. Chapter 3 is about overview of investment. In this overview of investment, we are going to see investment in general. In this, we are going to see overview of investment in chapter 3. In this, investment in general, the investment decision process, important considerations under investment decision process, and investment alternatives like money market, fixed income, equity, derivatives, different investment alternatives we are going to discuss, and return and risk investment. When you are doing investment, we expect some return as well as we face some risk. So relating to the risk and return of the investment also we are going to see. And last one, asset pricing models analysis that we are going to discuss. So these are the aspects that we are going to cover in this chapter 3. And in general, what is investment? How we can say that? The first thing is that what is investment? What is investment? And the general definition, what you will say that money you earn is partly spent and the rest saved for the meeting future expenses. Whatever the salary that you are receiving every month, that some part of the money you may spend for day-to-day expenses and remaining money you may save for the meeting the future expenses. Future is uncertain. We don't know what will happen. And in the future, the cost of living may be increased due to the inflation. To meet that inflation, we do some savings and some investments. With that investment returns, we may overcome the cost of living, which has been increasing in the coming future. So that's why to meet our future expenses and inflation, we are making some investment from our savings. That is what one thing. And here when one formula is there to follow this, generally 90% of the public, what they follow every month is that income, monthly income minus expenses. They'll do day-to-day expenses and whatever is left after expense, after spent, they may save or invest. Means investment of income minus expenses is equals investment. That is 95% of the public they follow. But my suggestion is that what I follow, I strictly follow the formula is that first, income, salary received, that is income received minus investment. You put some target every month, 40%, 50% savings like that. First, you take receive income minus investment, that equals expense. Whatever is left, that must be spent on our day-to-day expenses. That is what the formula I follow. And every month, nearly 40%, whatever may be the things happens, 40% of the savings are being invested in different investment alternatives. That is a investment principle that we can say that. Need for investment. What is the need? Need for investment, if you see this, earn return on your idle resources. Whatever money you have spent, remaining amount may be there in your pocket or remaining amount may be there in your almare or in your house. So keeping in pocket and in almare is ideal resource. So that's why whatever is money, extra money that you have, that money can be invested and you can earn some return on your ideal resources. That's why the investment is being defined for that. And generate a specific sum of money for a specific goal in life. From today, you may save money. From a save money to buy a house in the future, to buy a car in the future, to buy a like insurance policies or some other expensive items, to buy a furnitures, you may save money. So that's why generate a specific sum of money for a specific goal in life. For children education purpose, they may save money or invest money. Some of them for a house, some of them are for car, some of them save money for the future furniture, to buy the furniture in the future. Like that, there are some specific goals in life. To meet that goals, they are investing. And make a provision for the uncertain future. As I already told you, future is very uncertain. In this COVID, corona situation, I think many of them are losing the jobs in the world. So all of a sudden, if you lose the job, you need to have immediate reserves or cash reserves or investments you need to have so that you can protect yourself from the financial crunch. That's why investment is needed to make a provision for uncertain future. So anything may be uncertain in the future. So in that uncertain conditions, these investments may be utilized for living the things. So that's why that is one thing. And one more thing is that inflation. Inflation, if you see, what is the meaning of inflation here? If you see this inflation, the inflation is a rate at which the cost of living is increasing. What is the inflation rate in Ethiopia? In Ethiopia, the inflation rate is almost 11%. Means living things, goods and services are being increased every month or every year by 11%. That's why inflation rate at which cost of living is increases. Cost of living is simply what it costs to buy the goods and services you need to live everyday life. So that's why every day in your life, whatever the goods and services that you are purchasing, that goods cost may be increased day by day. That is called inflation. That is called. So inflation causes to lose money value. So that's why you see, for example, today, say the shinkurta, onions, shinkurta price, say for example, 10 birr, today 1 kilo shinkurta. And next 1 month or next 2 months, the same shinkurta cost may be 20 birr. Means today, 10 birr is equals 1 kilogram shinkurta. Next month, the same 1 kilo shinkurta is 20 birr. Means money value has been decreased. Cost has been increased and money value has been decreased. That is what inflation causes money to lose value. So, for example, if you see, if there was a 6% inflation rate for the next 20 years, say for example, this is INR, Indian rupee worth 100 rupees worth of good would cost 321 in 20 years. Means at the rate of 6% inflation rate, today 100 rupees worth of goods may become 321 worth in 20 years at the rate of 6% inflation. That's why the inflation leads to increase in goods and services cost. So that is what major one thing. And return. Yeah, I already told you that a return always plays linked with the investment. So return above inflation rate to ensure that investment does not decrease in value. Say, for example, in Ethiopia, inflation and return and expense, if you see, when you are spending money, your inflation cost is 11%. When you are investing money, your return percentage is only maximum 7%, maximum 7%. Because if you do fixed deposits or bonds, if you make not more than 7% that you earn in Ethiopia, at the treasury yield, bond yield is just less than 4% here. But inflation rate is 11%. That's why all the returns are negative in Ethiopia in all the time because of inflation is high. So, for example, if the annual inflation rate is 6%, then the investment will need to earn more than 6% to ensure that increase in value. So, always your investment return should be more than inflation rate so that the investment value may increase. So, if after tax return on your investment is less than the inflation rate, then your asset have actually decreased in value. So, that's why your investment return always should be more than inflation rate. They should see that always your investment return should be more than inflation rate. And if you see just an example which I have taken from Indian perspective, fixed deposit, gold, share, mutual fund, these are the various investment alternatives. Under these investment alternatives, inflation is 8.82%. Under this 8 to 82%, if you see fixed deposits in India, 8.5% approximately. Approximately, I'm taking this, and gold approximately it is giving 10 to 12%, and share. So all investment returns are more than the inflation rate, so that your assets value may get increased. That is what the one example that we can take from India. And golden rules of investment. What is a golden rule invest early. You invest it today at the early age, that may give the benefit of the compounding value, you know, investment compound or interest compound, compounded interest. So investment may become compounded when you invest early. And you have to start it. The moment you start earning, immediately you should start investing so that your value may get compounded, your interest returns maybe get compounded. So that's why invest regularly. If you start today, don't stop with 1 year or 2 years. You invest regularly every month. This month amount percentage 20%, 30%. Every month you regularly invest so that your returns may be increased and compounded. And invest for a long period, not the short period. Just now I told you, don't invest for 1 month or 1 year like that. You make it at least 10 years, 15 years continuously. If you invest, your money value would grow and your investment may get, investment return may get compounded. That's why these are the three rules of golden rules of investment. And if you see these important steps for investing, what are the important steps involving in investment? You have to read the documents explaining the investment. Whatever the investment that you are doing, whether it is share investment, or bank investment, or bonds investment, or mutual fund investment, that related documents must be clearly seen and clearly should understand. Read and understand such documents related to the investment and verify the legitimacy of the investment, how far it is worthful, is it needed to you or not. You have to verify about the legitimacy of the investment and find out the cost and benefit associated with the investment. Cost and benefit means some people are doing that investment, processing cost or processing charges they may take. And sometimes on your returns, investment, when you are getting the return, and that return they may impose the tax. So what are the costs and benefits associated with the investment? Is this investment is a tax-free, like a tax-exempted investment or not? All these things you have to find costs and benefits associated with the investment and assess the risk-return profile of the investment. As I told you that at the moment you start investment, that there will be a return as well as risk also. You may expected return may not be up to the mark and that may lead to risk. So deviating the result from your expectation is called risk. So that's why assess the risk and return profile of the investment and know the liquidity and safety aspects of the investment. Liquidity, immediately, if you need money, can I sell off this investment and make it money, make it in cash? Or can I make it in liquidity? Can I sell immediately and get the cash? So that is what liquidity. So liquidity and safety aspects. Safety means how far it is secure. Is it a good company, good investment or not? We have to see that and ascertain if it is appropriate for your specific goal. I already told you that you may investing or saving money for a specific goal to buy a house, to buy a car, to buy a furniture or for children's education. So is that investment is appropriate for your specific goal or not? We have to see that and compare these details with other investment opportunities available. You are buying a mutual fund, one or bank deposits. Bank deposits, you see that bank fixed deposits are bonds, one company, one bank to another bank, the interest rate may be different. Or when you are investing in shares, the share prices may be different. So like this, you compare the competitive investment alternatives or opportunities available in the same category. And examine if it fits with other investments you are considering or you have already made it. Yeah, whatever investment you are planning, is that investment already is there? Already you might have investing the same investment. Once you check that and deal only through the authorized intermediary brokers. Intermediary means middlemen. So those who have licenses, with them only you have to deal with the investment activities and seek all clarifications about the intermediary and the investment. Intermediaries means brokerage charges. Middlemen, they may charge more commission. So you have to see all those intermediaries before investing money and explore the options available to you if something were go wrong. Some company may be cheated you, they may cheat you like that. When they cheat and when you are losing money, okay, what is the alternative for that? How can you get back the money? So then if it is satisfied, then make the investment. So these are the investment alternatives and steps to be followed while investing money. And one more thing, if you see this interest, I already told you interest rate is the interest you may get on debt securities. Debt securities, you know, bonds, debentures, fixed deposit, bank savings, all these will earn the interest, and shares will earn the dividends. So that's why interest. When we borrow money, we are expected to pay for using it. So when you are giving hand loans or giving, or when you borrow money from bank or any other friend, you are supposed to pay some money, that is called interest. So an amount charged to the borrower who is taking money from them, it may be charged for the privilege of using the lender's money. Lenders means we are giving. Giver and borrower means taker. So the between these two, interest may be exchanged. So lender may pay the interest to the borrower. So calculated as a percentage of the principal of the balance. I already told you that interest always been calculated in percentage. Bank interest 6%, 7%, like that. Interest always been calculated with the percentage. And factors determine the interest, which when interest rate being increased or decreased, what factors can be determined in the fluctuations of the interest rate? You see this demand for money. If more demand for money, more interest may be charged. That is one thing. Level of government borrowings. If government level of government borrowings, when the central government is borrowing at a higher cost from the central bank, then automatically the market interest rates also been increased. So based on the government borrowings also, interest may increase or decrease. Supply of money. If more supply of money is there, means less interest may be available. So that's why supply of money has been controlled by RBI. When supply of money is more, the interest rate would be less. So that's why one more thing, the inflation rate. Inflation rate. When inflation rate is higher, then when inflation rate is higher, then automatically the banks, the central bank will come into the picture and they'll try to increase the interest rates, because they'll try to increase the interest rate. Inflation rate is high means purchasing power of the public is more. When why purchasing power of the public is more? Money supply is more. Why money supply is more? Less interest rates. Why less interest rates? So that's why every public is taking loans, heavy loans, and money supply is more. So in that case, immediately the central bank will come into the picture and they'll try to reduce the they'll try to increase the interest rates when inflation rate has been increasing, like this. So RBI means Reserve Bank of India. It is a government of India, Indian Central Bank, RBI, Reserve Bank of India, and government policies which determine the sum of the variable mentioned above. So like this in Ethiopia, like NBE, National Bank of Ethiopia, and the government of Ethiopia, these two activities will determine the interest rates all the times. So all the times, this is one thing. And options for investment. What are the different options available for the investment? Like if you see options for investment, physical assets, you know, physical assets which we can feel, touch, and we can take. So real estate, gold, jewelry, commodities. So these are the physical assets which we can invest. Real estate means land, buildings, all these. Gold ETFs, exchange traded funds, gold biscuits, ornaments, jewelry, we can invest. And commodities like agri commodities, you can invest in agri commodities with the derivatives contracts. Derivatives contract, which we are going to discuss in the coming classes. And financial assets. What are those financial assets? The assets which are there in the paper form. Paper form, on paper only. We cannot carry or we cannot physically touch that asset. It is in a paper form only. Financial asset means paper form. So fixed deposit, so small saving investments, mutual funds, pension funds, security market investments like shares, bonds, debentures. So all these things comes under financial assets. So these are the two different assets that are available for investment. So we'll see one by one. If you see this, If you see this investment, short-term financial options of investment, short-term investments, what are the investment options available for the short period of time? One is that saving bank account. It's very less interest rate it may give. And money market and liquid funds. We already discussed in the previous classes, money market instruments like commercial papers, treasury bills, call money market. So all those investments comes under money market or liquid funds. And one more thing, the fixed deposits. So compared to these two returns, fixed deposit returns may be little higher. So these are the, some sort of short-term financial option investments which are available for investment. One more thing is that a saving bank account. One by one we'll see that. Saving bank, money market and fixed deposit. One by one we'll see. Here is that a saving bank account. What is, you know, I think all of you have may have a bank account, all of you. You're saving money in the saving bank account. First banking product for the people to use. First, the immediately the investment option is that saving bank. Whatever the excess money you have, you may deposit in your bank account, saving bank account. Follow low interest rate. I already told you that my maximum deposit rate, saving bank deposit rate is 4 to 5% per annum. Interest is taxable in the hands of investor. Already you know that in Ethiopia, every month they credit the interest to your bank account, but out of that 5% tax may be debited again. Immediately, when your interest has been credited to your saving bank account, immediately they will debit 5% tax from your interest saving, savings interest. So 5% tax may be applied on this saving bank interests. So that is one thing. And money market and liquid funds, already we discussed in the previous classes, money market and liquid funds, already we discussed this in the previous classes. Money market is a specialized form of mutual funds that are invested extremely short term for 1 month, for 3 months, like that. We may invest primarily protecting your capital and then aim to maximize the returns. The mutual funds are money market instruments are, it is protecting your money, not losing the money. First, it will protect the capital and it will slowly, it will maximize the returns. That is what the specialty of the money market instruments. Money market funds usually yield better than the saving account. I already told you, compared to saving account, money market instruments are moderate returns they may give compared to saving, but lower than the fixed deposits. Fixed deposits may be better than the money market instruments. So this is one thing that we can discuss about the money market or liquid funds, which we can sell immediately and we can make the liquidity in cash. And fixed deposits with the bank. One more thing is that fixed deposits in the bank. Fixed deposits in the bank, with the bank, referred to as a term deposits. Terms means 6 months or 1 year or 2 years. You may deposit your money for a fixed period of time. So referred to as a term deposit. And minimum investment period for the bank FDs is 30 days. Minimum 30 days period you must invest in the bank. And FDs with the bank are for investment with the low risk appetite, because it is guaranteed by the National Bank, so that it is very low risk investment. Fixed deposit is only low risk investment. And FDs is lower than the money market funds returns. FDs are giving lower than money market funds sometimes. So that depends. Fixed deposit rates and saving bank deposit rates are depends upon the central bank decisions. Sometimes it may be higher, sometimes it may be lower. So this is what fixed deposits with the banks. And one more thing is the long-term financial instruments. If you see long-term financial instrument, those are all, previously we have seen short-term, like a saving bank account, money market and fixed deposits, all those are all short-term funds. Now, long-term financial investments, post office savings schemes. Here I'm taking a new schemes. These are all, these schemes are not available in, most of the schemes are not available in Ethiopia. I have taken the example from India. post office savings scheme, do you think these schemes are not available in Ethiopia? And public provident fund, I think PF, provident fund, I think you have this scheme for pension. Every month from employee, 7% pension may be deducted and 11% may be contributed from the government. So public provident fund, it is alternative name for in Ethiopia, like a pension fund. And fixed company fixed deposits, like a company also will take some sort of funds and for a fixed period of time for a certain interest. And bonds and debentures, bonds, company may be issued and government also may issue for a longer period. So bonds and debentures and mutual funds. These are the five investment alternatives which are there for a longer period of time, which are there for a longer period of time. We'll see one by one. And post office, you know, India, very large country, and it has a network all over country, India. They have services available in every remote village. So every remote village, post offices are available. The post offices itself are making some savings schemes. The public can go and deposit some money with the post offices, and for that, the government will give some sort of interest. So like this, in every remote villages, post offices are encouraging for saving money at a low risk saving instrument. Low risk because it has been guaranteed. Post office has been run by central government. So it is under control of central government. So that's why risk is very low and provides an interest rate at the maximum 8% per annum paid monthly. 8%, whatever amount you are depositing with the post offices, they are giving 8% 8% monthly interest they'll pay. And minimum amount can be invested 1,000. From 1,000, even 500 also may be invested. They changed the rule now. Minimum amount can be invested 1,000, and maturity period is period of 6 years. Maturity period also see up to 6 years to 10 years like this. So when you are investing money, when you are saving money for the savings, central government will support by giving 8% interest for your savings. So that is what post office savings, one of the long-term investment alternative. And one more thing is that, the public provident fund. I already told you that it is alternative name in Ethiopia. In Ethiopia, pension fund, we can say that. Pension fund, you are contributing 7% and government is contributing 11%. Total 18% contribution will be there for your pension fund. But in India, not like that. They'll call it as a public provident fund. Public provident fund, every month they deduct and 50% employee contribution, another 50% employee contribution like that. So the long-term saving investment with the maturity of 15 years, up to 15 years you can invest, and interest, 8% interest may be payable for your amount which has been deducted from your salary. And a PPF account can be opened through public provident fund. Account can be opened with any nationalized bank. So like that, you can save money and you can get 8% return from your public provident fund investments. This is an investment alternative in India, which is working. And company fixed deposits, I already told you, some of the companies, they take the deposits from the public and they'll give fixed rate of interest. Fixed rate of interest. These are the short-term and medium-term borrowings at a fixed interest. So time period, maybe 1 year, more than 1 year. The time period is different. Time periods may be there. And payable monthly, quarterly, and semi-annually. So monthly interest, monthly interest plus principal are 6 months, 3 months, like that. They can pay it back on different terms. And rate of interest between 6 to 9%, because company fixed deposit rate of return is higher than the fixed deposits with the banks, and interest received after deduction of the taxes. So it is whatever the interest you are raising through this company fixed deposit, it is subjected to tax. And one more thing is that bonds. So you know, bonds, anything in Ethiopia, many of the banks are issuing the bonds, and it is a fixed income instrument issued for a period of more than one year. The time period would be there, and purpose of raising the capital. Why they are issuing the bonds? They want to raise the capital from the public. So that's why they are issuing the bonds. These bonds can be issued by the bank as well as the companies. I think in Ethiopia, many of the companies are not doing this, but in India, companies as well as banks both will issue the bonds for raising the capital from the public. And a promise to repay the principal along with the fixed rate of interest specific date. So it is a promise. Bond means it is a promise to repay the principal with the interest. So that's why these bonds are been well famous in every country. And mutual fund, you know that the mutual fund is an investment which facilitates the small investors. What is a mutual fund? Operated by an investment company which raises money from the public and invest in the group of assets. I don't know ABCD of share market, but I want to invest in share market. So company, mutual fund company can help you out. They take money from you and on behalf of you, they'll invest in the stock market, and whatever the returns they are getting, that returns may be taken, 1 or 2% return commission may be taken, and remaining amount may be given back to you, the investor. So that's why it is helping to the public come in mutual fund companies. And substitute those who are unable to invest directly in equities or debt because of resources, time, lack of knowledge constraints. If you don't have a knowledge on shares, bonds and all, then you give money to the mutual fund companies. They'll invest you on behalf of you, they'll invest and they'll give some sort of returns to you by taking some sort of commission. And usually long-term investments vehicle. Bonds are like a mutual funds are long-term investments only. Every month I am also doing every month 1,000 automatically it will be debited from my bank account. Every month I am also investing through mutual funds. They are giving some every month 1,000 rupees I am giving, and they'll invest in a stock market on behalf of me. So like this investment, it is an investment alternative for the investors, those who don't have money, those who don't have knowledge, time to invest. For them, mutual fund is perfect. And share, you know that share is one of the thing which are been issued by the companies, Share means like, what is the meaning of share? The total equity capital of company is divided into units of small denomination. Say for example, we are planning to raise the money through shares. So how much you are planning? Say for example, 1 million. 1 million capital is required. 1 million divided by 10. Face value is 10. So 1 million divided by 10. If you take that may become 1 lakh shares. 1 lakh shares. So they may issue. There 1 million capital has been divided into small units with the 10 bir. So that total units are 1 lakh. So 1 lakh shares may be issued. The holder of such shares are members of the company have voting rights. Those who are buying company shares, they may become a shareholder and they may have the voting rights. For example, if a company's total equity is, say for example, 2 million. 2 million is divided into 20. Then it may become 10 each. 2 billion, sorry. 2 billion is divided by 2 million. So each share has been divided into 10 each. So each such unit is called, rupees 10 is called a share. So that's why small denominator. This is 10 is the face value. So that's why if it's on, 10 is the face value. Like that, companies can divide their capital into small units. That small unit has been called shares, and the shares have been issued to the public. And one more investment alternative is the derivative. This derivative concept we will discuss in the coming classes, because the sixth chapter is totally derivatives concept only. It is very new financial instrument which markets have been following, and many developed countries are following these derivative contracts. A product whose value is derived from the value of one or more basic variables is called underlying. So the total definition examples we will discuss in the coming classes on derivatives concept, because sixth chapter we are discussing about derivatives. So in that chapter we'll discuss what is this derivative and all. So thank you for listening, and this is chapter 3 part 1, And next, I'm going to make chapter 3, part 2. Chapter 3, part 2. So I'll make. Thank you for listening.